love it, and I know you guys are going to love it. So on that note, I think I want to introduce Lisa because she is my muse. If she had not told me that story, this would have never happened, and our life would look really different. In 2012, the book came out by Pelican Publishing, and Lisa's story is before my story because she started it all. Lisa, Vinny, get your butt up here. I love you, girlfriend. Thanks, Annitti. Vinny, welcome, Lisa and Annitti. The New Jersey girl, I call it.
Okay. Hi, everyone.
Hi.
So, my story starts the night before Thanksgiving, when I found myself lonely and depressed, trying really hard to get over a devastating breakup in Shreveport, Louisiana. So you're probably wondering why this New Jersey transplanted to California girl was in Shreveport. Was there for you? You don't believe me, do you? Actually, I was there because I ran away from Los Angeles because my heart was broken. The love of my life, the guy who, when you meet him, you know that you never want to go on a date again, and you thank God that you found him, broke up with me. And I needed to put a little distance between us. So anyway, I was invited to a wonderful Thanksgiving dinner in Baton Rouge with the Sweeneys, but my boss at the time coerced me to go to an orphan's meal. Do you know what that is, where they invite people who have nowhere else to go? Yeah. Really depressing at her home in Shreveport. Well, it turns out that her, mother was a gourmet cook. And I was like, anyway, her mother was a gourmet cook. And I thought, well, this won't be so bad. You know, gourmet cook, great dinner. That's until I saw the menu, which didn't even include the most basic Thanksgiving fare, mashed potatoes. Who has Thanksgiving without mashed potatoes? And the dessert menu was worse. No pies. No pumpkin pie, no pecan pie, and not even my all-time favorite coconut cream pie. So, the generous person that I am, I decided to bring a coconut cream pie. Well, if looks could kill, I would have been a dead woman. But my boss, ever polite, said that would be fine. So now it's the night before Thanksgiving, and I run out of my office to Strawn's Bake Shop to get my pie, and I am so excited. I get back to the office, and the powers that be say, you can leave early today for the holiday. Yippee! No yippee, because I'm alone in Shreveport. Dinner's not till 5 o'clock the next day. What am I supposed to do alone for the next 27 hours? So, pull myself up by my bootstraps, and I go to the grocery store, and I get some pork chops and some Brussels sprouts, and I get a bottle of wine, and I go home, and I decide I'm going to make this really wonderful home-cooked meal. Sounds great, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, not so much, because that leads me back to the beginning of my story, where I'm trying really hard to get over a devastating breakup in my corporate apartment in Shreveport, Louisiana. I don't know if you've been to Shreveport, but trust me. Anyway, so it's about 5:30, and I put on my pajamas, my pork chops are marinating, and I think to myself, it's not too early to open that bottle of wine, is it?
Never.
Well, the next thing I know, I have practically licked my plate clean and polished off the entire bottle of wine. So in my drunken haze, I start to think to myself, you know, Lisa, you should have got some ice cream at the store, something sweet, because I know after I drink, I want something sweet. And that's when I hear a voice from the kitchen. Lisa, Lisa, eat me, eat me. And that's when I remember I have pie. So I know what you're all thinking, the pie is for Thanksgiving dinner, but remember, I am drunk. Drunk people can rationalize almost anything. So I say, I'm gonna take that pie, I'm gonna cut it in half, and I'm gonna put it on a plate, and I'll bring the rest for dinner. Right, sounds reasonable. I go to the refrigerator, and I take out my pie, and it was so beautiful. I cut myself a slice, I take the first bite, and it was so rich and creamy and cold in my mouth, I almost couldn't swallow it. but swallowed I did. And the next thing I know, I'm no longer cutting slices. Thank you. I'm no longer cutting slices, but I'm eating the pie out of the tin with a fork. Yes, I can bring this pie to dinner. Only now, I'll cut up whatever slices are left and put them on a little plate. They didn't want that pie anyway, right?
They didn't want any of this.
Nope, they didn't want that pie. Well, next thing I know, my phone rings, and it's my friend Sherry from LA. And she says, oh my God, they let us out of work early. And I was so depressed, I had nothing to do. I went home and I drank a bottle of wine, and now I'm drunk on my ass on my couch. Well, they say misery loves company, don't they? So I tell her, guess what? You're not alone. Because I'm drunk off my ass on my couch, and at least you're not in Shreveport. So then I start to tell her about the pie. I'm not a second into my story when she blurts out, you can't bring that freaking pie. Are you out of your mind? What are you thinking? I'm like, yes, 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 I can bring that pie. I'm going to cut it in slices and put it on a plate. I'll be... Oh, crap. She's right. I can't bring that pie. So then she says, well, what are you going to do? Well, if I can't bring it with me, I'm going to eat that thing. And I ate that whole pie, and it was delicious. So now I wake up the next morning, and I'm on my couch because I've not made it to the bed. And I look over, and I see my two cats, not one, I have two, licking the crumbs out of the tin. Like, oh my God, Lisa, what did you do last night? So finally, I get myself together and I have to leave the house and go to my boss's. On the way out, I grab a bottle of wine because I have nothing else to bring, and hair of the dog's not so bad. So anyway, I drive myself to my boss's house, I get there, I ring the doorbell, she answers the door, and in my most unhungover voice, I say, Happy Thanksgiving, and I hand her the bottle of wine. She looks at me, she looks at the wine, and she says, where's my pie? Okay, that's my story, that was my beautiful Thanksgiving. Thank you.
Started this whole journey, and meanwhile back at Café Du Monde. I love you, Lisa. You're my beautiful friend. What a journey this has been. So our next, Lisa, wait, come up here. If you were a food, Lisa, what would you be and why? I forgot to ask you the famous question.
If I were a food, it's ding-dong. I'm from Jersey, so I'm hard on the outside, but oh so soft in the middle.